Hello friends, in this session we will be talking about Pythagoras theorem and other related theorems. So we have this theorem which states that if a perpendicular is drawn from the vertex of a right angle of a right angled triangle to the hypotenuse, then the triangles on both sides of the perpendicular are similar to the whole triangle. So we are saying if we draw this BD, which is perpendicular, it is a perpendicular drawn from the vertex of the right angle, which is B, to the hypotenuse. So which means that this BD is perpendicular to AC such that both these angles become 90 degree. So now, according to this theorem, triangle on both sides of the perpendicular, which means ADB and BDC, these two triangles are similar to the whole triangle, which is ABC, the original complete right angle triangle, which was ABC. Now let's see, how do we prove that? Now in this right angled triangle ABC, we draw this BD perpendicular to AC. Now we take this triangle ADB and ABC. In this triangle, we know that angle A is common, and we know that angle ADB is equal to angle ABC, both of which are 90 degree. So by AA criteria of similarity, these two triangles are similar. Now, if we take triangle BDC and triangle ABC, again we know angle C is common in these two triangles, and angle BDC is equal to angle ABC, both being 90 degree. So again by AA criteria, these two triangles are similar. So hence the theorem, which says that if we draw a perpendicular from the right angle vertex on the hypotenuse of a right angle triangle, then the right triangles formed on both sides of this perpendicular are similar to the original triangle. So now let's look at the Pythagoras theorem. The theorem states that in a right angled triangle, the square of hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides of the triangle. So if we have this triangle ABC, we are saying according to the theorem, AC square, the square of the hypotenuse, which is AC square, is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides, which means AB square plus BC square. So now let's prove it. In this right angle triangle ABC, we draw BD perpendicular to AC. Now we already know that ABD triangle is similar to ABC, which would mean that the corresponding sides will be proportional, which means AD by AB will be equal to AB by AC. AD and AB both being the height of the right angle triangle, and AB and AC being the hypotenuse of these corresponding triangles. So we are saying these are proportional. So we can say AB square is equal to AD into AC. Similarly, if we take triangle BDC and ABC, which are similar, we can say DC by BC is equal to BC by AC, or we can say BC square is equal to DC into AC. Now adding 1 and 2, we get AB square plus BC square is equal to AD into AC plus DC into AC. So AC we can take out from this side, we get AB square plus BC square is equal to AC into AD plus DC. So AD plus DC is nothing but AC. So AB square plus BC square become equal to AC square. Hence, proved the Pythagoras theorem for a right angled triangle. Now we have the converse theorem, which says that in a triangle, if the square of one side is equal to the sum of squares of other two sides, then the angle opposite to that side is a right angle. So if we have this triangle and it is given that in this triangle AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. So we have to prove that angle B will be equal to 90 degree. Now we draw another triangle PQR such that PQ is equal to AB, QR is equal to BC, and this angle is 90 degree. Angle Q is 90 degree. Now in this triangle PQR, PQ square plus QR square is equal to PR square by Pythagoras theorem, because we know that this is a right angle triangle, and as per the Pythagoras theorem this holds true. Now we can replace PQ by AB and QR by BC. So we get AB square plus BC square is equal to PR square. But from 1, this, we are given AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square, which would mean that AC square is equal to PR square, or AC is equal to PR. Now, if the three sides of these two triangles are equal, then by SSS congruency rule, these two triangles are congruent, which would mean angle B is equal to angle Q is equal to 90 degree. So this is the converse of Pythagoras theorem. Now let's see another theorem which is based on the Pythagoras theorem. So now this theorem says that an obtuse triangle, obtuse angle at B, if AD is perpendicular to BC, so we draw AD perpendicular to BC, BC extended obviously, then AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square plus 2 into BC into BD. Now we'll prove this. We draw AD perpendicular to BC extended. Angle B is obtuse angle, which is given. Obtuse angle at B. Now in this right angled triangle ABD, ADB, we have AB square. We're talking about this triangle. AB square is equal to AD square plus DB square by Pythagoras theorem. In the right angled triangle ADC, now we're talking about this bigger triangle. AC square is equal to AD square plus DC square. So, now this AC square can be said to be equal to AD square plus, we say DC is equal to DB plus BC. So we say AC square is equal to AD square plus DB plus BC whole square. And when we open it, we get AC square is equal to AD square plus DB square plus BC square plus 2 into BC into BD. And we know AD plus DB square is nothing but AB square. So we replace this, we get AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square plus 2 into BC into BC into BD. So this is based on the Pythagoras theorem, but this is for the obtuse triangles, obtuse angle at B. We can say that an obtuse angle triangle, the square of the side opposite the obtuse angle, which is AC, is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides plus twice the product of one side and the projection of the other on the first. So, product of one side, which is BC, and projection of the other side, which is AB, on the first side, which is BC. So, projection of AB on BC is BD. So it is the sum of the square of other two sides plus twice the product of one side and the projection of the other on first. So now it is important to understand that if we draw it in a different way, if we, instead of drawing AD as the perpendicular, if we draw the perpendicular from C on AB extended, then also we'll get a similar thing, and we name this point say D dash. Then we'll also get AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square plus 2 into one side, which would have been AB, and the projection of BC on AB, which is BD dash. So this would become just this part would change to 2 into AB into BD dash. Now we have another one based on the Pythagoras theorem. This is related to the acute triangles. In an acute triangle, acute angled at B, if AD is perpendicular to BC, then AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square minus 2 into BC into BD. So we have now this triangle ABC, which is acute triangle. Acute angle we are taking at B. We draw AD, which is perpendicular to BC. Now we take the triangle ADB. We know AB square is equal to AD square plus DB square by Pythagoras theorem. And in the triangle ADC, we know AC square is equal to AD square plus DC square. Now DC can be replaced by BC minus BD. This DC is equal to this side, which is BC minus BD. So we've just replaced this. Now we can say AC square is equal to AD square plus BD square plus BC square minus 2BC into BD. So AD square plus DB square again is nothing but AB square. So we replace that. So AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square minus 2BC into BD. So we can say that in an acute angled triangle, the square of the side of opposite side, the square of the side opposite to the acute angle is equal to the sum of squares of the other two sides minus twice the product of one side and the projection of the other on the first. Again, in a similar way, we are saying B is the acute angle that we are talking about. So AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square minus, here it is, minus twice the product of one side, which is BC, and the projection of the other, which is AB on BC, which is nothing but BD. BD is the projection of AB on the side BC. So this is what we get. So friends, now let's look at another theorem which is based on Pythagoras theorem. It states that in a triangle, the sum of squares of any two sides is equal to the twice the square of half of the third side together with twice the square of median, which bisects the third side. Now let's see what does this theorem state. So we have this triangle ABC and we have AD as the median of on BC and AE drawn perpendicular to BC, and this side is equal to this side. So BD is equal to DC because D is the median on BC. Now in the obtuse triangle ABD, so we are talking about this triangle, we have AB square is equal to AD square plus BD square plus 2BD into DE. So this is, we know, we have just talked about this theorem. In the acute triangle ADC, we have AC square is equal to AD square plus DC square minus 2 into DC into DE. Now, if we add these two, we get AB square plus AC square is equal to twice of AD square plus DB square plus DC square plus 2 into BD into DE minus 2 into DC into DE. Now we know BD is equal to DC. So we can say this term will cancel with this term. And we know DB is equal to DC. So we can write this as 2 dB square. So we have AB square plus AC square is equal to twice of AD square plus DB square. This is what the theorem says, that sum of the squares of any two sides, AB square plus AC square, is equal to twice the square of half of the third side, which is DB, together with twice the square of the median, which is AD, which bisects the third side. So we are talking about AB square plus AC square. Now the third side is BC. So AB square plus AC square is equal to twice of the half of the third side, which is BD square, plus the median on the third side, which is AD square. So this is what the theorem states. Now moving to another theorem based on the Pythagoras theorem, it says that in a triangle, 3 times the sum of squares of the sides of a triangle is equal to 4 times the sum of squares of the medians of the triangle. So we have this triangle ABC and we have these 3 medians AD, BE and CF. We want to prove 3 times the sum of squares of the sides of a triangle, which would mean 3 times of AB square plus BC square plus AC square, will be equal to 4 times the sum of squares of the medians, which is AD square plus BE square plus CF square. Now we prove it. So we draw these 3 medians. Now by the previous theorem, we know that AB square plus AC square is equal to 2 times of AD square plus DB square. DB square can be written as BC by 2 whole square. So we get AB square plus AC square is equal to 2 times of AD square plus BC square by 4. Or we can also say, we can just cross multiply this 2 here. We get 2 on the left hand side. 2 times of AB square plus AC square is equal to 4 times of AD square plus BC square. Similarly, if we take AB and BC as the sides, so we can say 2 times of AB square plus BC square will be equal to 4 times of BE square plus AC square. And if we take AC and BC as the sides, we'll say 2 times of AC square plus BC square is equal to 4 times of CF square plus AB square. So now we add these 3. We get 4 times of AB square plus AC square plus BC square is equal to 4 times of AD square plus BE square plus CF square plus AB square plus AC square plus BC square. This one. Now, taking these 3 to the left hand side, we'll get 3 times of AB square plus AC square plus BC square equal to 4 times of AD square plus BE square plus CF square, which is nothing but 3 times the square of the 3 times the sum of squares of the sides of the triangle is equal to 4 times the sum of the squares of the medians of this same triangle. So this is the theorem. Friends, I hope you enjoyed the session. If you find it useful, please like it and share it with your friends. You can visit us at our Cool Smart Learning website and post your queries there. And please subscribe to the Cool Smart Learning channel for getting updates on the new sessions. Thank you.